Here we have calorie pear, a major invasive species. It is a problem. But just want to show this technique. We call this brushing when you're using a chainsaw and smaller diameter stems. But I've even done this in mountain bogs, Appalachian mountain bogs, where we've cut back maple and other woody vegetation that encroaches in those ecosystems. So this could be used in a variety of places. But again, smaller stem woody plants. So we've removed them, but they will sprout back. So what you want to do then is treat these individual stumps and just one squirt per stump. That should do it. So here I've got a sweet gum, and I'm gonna use this method, which is hack and squirt. So I have a hatchet, I've got my squirt bottle of herbicide. Every time I squeeze the trigger on the herbicide bottle, the spray bottle, it's gonna release 1 milliliter of solution. So that's important. And of course, when you read the label, you'll know how much you need. So a mazapyr, which is Arsenal AC in this case, I would just need to hack a tree every 3 to 4 inches. If I was using a different herbicide, like the glyphosate at 50% solution, then I'm gonna have to pretty much girdle the tree, hack about every inch of that particular tree. But make sure you get a good athletic stance and position yourself well, again, so that you're safe as you're swinging away. Make sure you look up too. That's gonna be important. You got a hard hat on, but look up to make sure there aren't any widowmakers or any loose branches or anything that might fall out of the tree on you. So a good athletic stance. We'll come in and hack this tree, and I'm gonna do that one spray. Come around this side, same thing. Hack it, spray it. And now if you'll notice, I've got this hatchet, I'm peeling the bark back, but I've created a cup trench, and that cup trench is gonna allow that herbicide then to sit there in those living cells. I broke through the bark layer, get into that cambium layer, and allow this tree to uptake that herbicide. Here you can see this is an American beech. And American beech is it's a native tree, but in this case, these smaller beech trees in the mid-story, they're casting shade in an area where we want more sunlight. So then, just another example, I can use hack and squirt. In this case, I'm gonna use a machete, and again, this should work well to where I'm zeroing in. I'm laser focused on using herbicide specifically on this tree and nothing else around it. So I really like this hack and squirt method to do some of this selective removal or control of species that are less desirable in some of these situations. So get a good athletic stance, come in. I'm gonna hack into this tree and I'm gonna spray. Come to this side, hack, and spray. It's a smaller diameter tree. And now that I've created that cup trench, most of that herbicide then is gonna sit there within those living cells. And the tissues of this tree then are gonna uptake that herbicide for an effective control. In this case here, we've got a sweet gum, but it's a larger diameter sweet gum. We could hack and squirt this tree, but another option is to use a small chainsaw and do girdle and spray. So girdling meaning I'm breaking through that bark layer, I'm getting to the cambium layer where those living cells are, all that nutrient and water flow is taking place there. So once you see in the video those milky white chips, I've officially broke through the bark layer, I'm in the cambium layer, and in that way I can officially girdle the tree. And some folks will say that girdling a tree alone with something like a chainsaw will work, or double girdling a tree. But if I'm gonna spend the time on this and knowing how all trees are, well, many of them are extremely resilient, I'm gonna use a herbicide to make sure that I've controlled this tree, utilize the herbicide then to spray the wound. down here, keep it below my belt line where my chaps are. Set my chain brake. I'm gonna shut that off. Now this is one where you could work together with another person, so they could be following you around with a spray bottle, and then you could switch and make it easier and much faster and more efficient as you work utilizing girdle and spray if you want to use this technique. Now I'm going to spray the wound, and I'm just getting that cambium layer then. I'm soaking the cambium layer. And now, this herbicide should be able to penetrate into the cells of this tree. And now you've officially or selectively removed it. You'll eventually have a snag too. So that might be worth mentioning, is having a variety of snags. You don't want them near trails or heavy use areas, but having snags out in the middle of the woods can be awesome for so many different species that utilize snags in that dead wood, not just for foraging on insects, but for excavating cavities. So a wide variety of birds and mammals especially would utilize snags. Yeah, and you may have trees that are larger diameter or some that you actually want to fell and then treat the stumps with herbicide. So that's what I'm going to demonstrate here. So this is not a felling how-to video per se, but always wear your PPE. Definitely have an escape route. You don't want to spend a lot of time under trees, even the green trees that are living. These smaller trees, a lot of times you can push them right over. And then I always look up, make sure nothing's gonna fall out on me. I finish my cut, so I cut my hinge off. And now I'm not gonna spray this whole stump because the heartwood, that's dead wood, the interior wood there. I just spray that outer layer, that cambium layer on the outside. And that should do it. We didn't get into the best time of year to utilize these techniques and to apply these herbicides. But really, any time of year is fine, except for the springtime when you have heavy sap flow from some of these trees, especially things like sugar maple. There are a variety of other species that'll have heavy sap flow during that springtime. And if you apply the herbicides with hack and squirt or even girdle and spray, sometimes that sap can wash the herbicide out. I like to use late growing season because it's easier to identify the trees. They have their leaves. And also in the fall of the year is a good time because it's starting to become cooler weather. And during that transition where these trees, especially hardwoods, are going to go dormant, they're actually going to take a lot of that herbicide straight to the roots. And it can be extremely effective. But keep in mind, when you do apply these techniques and these herbicides, it usually will take 2 or 3 months for those trees to succumb and be controlled. But behind me, you can see then American beech that was treated about 2 months ago with hack and squirt. And again, just trying to get more sunlight on the ground here to promote oak regeneration. So thanks for your time today. We went over a few techniques then, dealing with stem injections, utilizing hack and squirt and girdle and spray, even the cut stump method. So you got to see some of the tools of the trade, some of the herbicides that we generally would recommend. Some of our woods are in desperate need of management, whether it's non-native invasive species or whether it's our native forests. They're being overtaken by even some species that we would consider native invasive on a particular site. So trying to create desirable forested conditions and promote forest health in a more sustainable and resilient forest for the future. So thanks for joining us again today. Hopefully some of this you will be able to use as you go out and maybe join us in managing your woods.